this idea that Vice President Mike Pence could shut down the Electoral College vote on January 6th. Another very big fish, one of the biggest fish, that is former Vice President Mike Pence. Benny Thompson, chairman of that House Select Committee, making clear to CNN that they would like to speak with him, again, in a voluntary capacity. So again, Jim, they're zeroing in on the people who made Trump miss.
And the idea, not so ludicrous, is that more than 100 GOP lawmakers voted that night to reject the votes of states, to reject them. Remarkable. Whitney Wild, thanks very much. As Attorney General Merrick Garland is set to update the Justice Department's criminal probe into the insurrection, CNN is learning more about what is still an ongoing hunt for this person, the person who planted pipe bombs at both the Republican and Democratic headquarters in Washington the night before January 6th. CNN senior justice correspondent Evan Perez. He has new reporting on this investigation. Evan, it's been a year and still don't have someone. Is there progress?
Yeah, look, over the past year, Jim, this has been an
bedtime!
This is the best super duper sleepover ever!
Just before the assault on the Capitol, and finally about 2 weeks
Good night, Purple Panda!
Good night, Donkey Hardy. I sat down with Steve Bono, who is the assistant director of the FBI's Washington field office, to talk about these priorities. So you've seen the videos.
What's wrong, Donkey?
There's a monster on the floor over there.
Where?
Over there.
In this case, it wasn't, because of the environment that we're living in during COVID times.
Well, one of the things you wonder is why the bombs didn't go off.
It must have been my imagination. Sorry about that, Panda.
No problem, Donkey. Is it okay if I turn the lights back out now?
It's okay by me.
Okay. Good night, Donkey.
Sleep tight. We hear from the Attorney General. We don't expect that he's going to talk about any specific cases. But to try to hold people accountable in the Trump administration, perhaps the former president himself, for what is essentially what people consider what was essentially a coup attempt on January 6th. And so we're going to hear some words about, you know, defending democracy. But again, we don't anticipate in the coming hours when he speaks that he's going to go into